Hello and welcome to this data quality tutorial. First, let us understand what is data quality. Now, basically, data is of high quality if it does not suffer from data issues. There are many possible issues with data. We will see multiple examples shortly. Now, data is used for many functions such as operations, customer management, marketing, analysis, and decision making. If the data is of poor quality, there are several problems like wastage of time and money due to incorrect reports, poor decisions, and frustration. Now, let us see examples of data issues. First issue is incompleteness. Here is a customer table with columns, first name, last name, billing address, shipping address, and email. For example, Dave has a billing address of 111 Main City Street and the email is dave@example.co. Now here, last name is missing, shipping address is missing, and the email is truncated. Robert has the default billing address and his shipping address is missing. It is also possible that the customer table misses records that exist in the source data, or the customer table is not updated. Second data quality issue is inaccuracy. Here is the employee table with columns name, position, department, and email. Now Anna's position and department is interchanged. Barry's position has a typo in software. Charles's department has a junk value. The third data quality issue is inconsistency. Here is the order table with columns, order number, customer ID, ship date, and total. Now, the totals are in different currency. This one is in dollars and this one is in euros. The currency should be consistent. Fourth data quality issue is invalidity. Here is the product table with columns, product code, name, units available, and retire date. Now units available is negative in this row, which is impossible. Also, widget 2 is already retired but still present in this table. The fifth data quality issue is redundancy. Here is a customer table with columns, first name, last name, and email. Now the second row is a duplicate of the first row because the email addresses are the same. The sixth data quality issue is non-standard. Here is the order table with columns, order number, customer ID, and total. In the second row, the total has four places after the decimal point, so it is in non-standard format. Now let us see the process of data quality assurance, which can be used by the data quality analyst. It has three main activities. First is data profiling. It involves exploring the data to understand and analyze it. Then identify the data quality issues and then summarize the data in table row counts, blank values, duplicates, and so on. If the data quality issue is widespread, the data quality is poorer. For example, if the customer table has 2% rows missing, the data quality is higher than if the customer table has 20% rows missing. Data quality can be expressed in data quality metrics such as percent complete, percent accurate, percent conformance, that means to business rules, like value should be greater than or equal to the lower range. Now, manual data profiling with SQL queries is effort intensive, so only a small subset of data can be profiled. However, tools like SQL Server data quality services do not need writing SQL queries and can run checks on the entire dataset quickly. The next activity in data QA is data cleansing. It involves fixing data issues. Simple updates fix data quality issues like misspellings, typos, incorrect formats, and missing foreign keys. In case of duplicates, one of the rows is selected as a master. Data in the duplicate rows is used to enrich the master or just discarded. Selective imports bring in the missing rows. Obsolete data is deleted. The important point is, due to the risk associated with data changes, such changes are not applied to the database directly. Each proposed change is listed and reviewed by a domain expert, also known as a data steward. The data steward approves or rejects proposed changes. Only the approved changes are applied by the data quality analyst. The next activity in data QA is data monitoring. The data should be maintained in a clean state. Users entering new data check business rules first. Users who consume data submit data quality issues for review. The data quality analyst runs checkers like parsers, spell checkers, business rule checkers, duplicate checkers, etc. to find out data quality issues and submit them to the data steward. If the data steward lacks in domain knowledge, he or she can use pre-built knowledge bases with business rules from multiple domains like address, zip code, etc. That's all in this video. Thank you and see you in my other videos on database normalization.